Good morning, all of you. Today we are discussing about the second portion of fundamental of accountancy, the fundamental of partnership, that is how to prepare partner's capital account. In class 11, we discussed about preparing the capital account of sole proprietorship. But in partnership, we need to prepare the partner's capital account of different partners. Now, why we require different capital account for different partners? Because the reason behind the same, in partnership, suppose three partners are here, name A, B, and C, and all A, B, C contribute different amount of capital. When they contributed different amount of capital, of course, they get interest in capital at the same rate, but the amount of interest in capital is depending upon how much capital they contributed in the business. The simple say, in partner's capital account, we have need to prepare the different capital account of three different partners or maybe four different partners depending on number of partners we have in the business. Now, in partnership, how we prepare partner's capital account? The partner's capital account can be divided into two parts. The first one is fixed capital account and the fluctuating capital account. We need to prepare, hame dekhna padega ki how we prepare partner's capital account. Question mein, what they ask? If they ask prepare fixed capital account, so we need to prepare two different accounts under this category. The first one is called capital account and the third one is called, second one is called current account. Please remember the same. Is cheez ko dhyan se dekhiyega. Under fixed capital method, we need to prepare two accounts. The first one is called capital account and the other one is called current account. But under fluctuating capital method, we need to prepare only one account, that we call it capital account. Now, important part is it, because in CBC accountancy paper, there are 20 questions are there which are objective type, obviously one mark questions. So these things, these questions or these basic steps are very important to know. How? In what condition the fixed capital account can be changed? The fixed capital account can be changed only in two conditions. First one is when any partner introduce further capital, or we say additional capital in the business. In this, is capital is created. And second condition, when it's make drawing against capital, when he withdraw the money out of his capital. In that condition, his capital is debited. In simple means, created means capital ka banna, debit means capital ka kamana. Credit with introduction of further capital and debited with drawing against capital. So these are two conditions on which the fixed capital account can be changed. Under any circumstances, the fixed capital account cannot be changed. Second thing, we need to prepare after capital account, we need to prepare current account. It's mandatory, it's compulsory. Now, how current account is created and debited? It's created with when partner get any salary, we call it remuneration. When he get any amount of interest on capital, his share of profit, that all increases capital. I repeat again, his capital is created or increased with the amount of salary or remuneration he gets by interest on capital, by share of profit, or we say if he get any commission. If you get all these things, its capital account is credited and is debited with drawing against profit. If you withdraw the money out of profit, interest run, the amount he need to pay on his drawing, his share of losses, these are things by which his capital is debited or means decreases. Now, this is the first one. So under fixed capital account, we need to prepare two capital accounts. The first one is called capital account, the other one is called current account. Under fluctuating method, we need to prepare only one account, and that account is called fluctuating capital method, or simply called capital method. We simply call capital account. It's debited with and it's credited with. Is credited with when he brings additional capital, his capital will increase. If you get interest on capital, next one is if you get any salary or remuneration, if you get any commission, if you get, apart from this thing, if you get any share of profit in the business, So these are things by which his capital will be increases. His debited wealth, when he withdraw the money out of the capital, out of capital or out of profit, in that condition his capital will be decreases. Similarly, if he pay any interest on his drawings, his capital will be debited. His share of losses in the business, he has to bear the losses, his capital will be debited. So these are the basic structure how to prepare partner's capital account. So partner's capital account in partnership divided into two parts, fixed capital method and fluctuating capital method. That's totally depend on the question, what the question asks. जो क्वेश्चन में पूछा गया होगा उसके अकॉर्डिंग हमें करना है. इफ द क्वेश्चन आस्क प्रिपेयर बाय फिक्स्ड कैपिटल मेथड, तो अंडर फिक्स्ड कैपिटल मेथड वी नीड टू प्रिपेयर टू अकाउंट्स. द फर्स्ट वन इज कॉल्ड कैपिटल अकाउंट, द अदर वन इज कॉल्ड करंट अकाउंट. बट इफ द क्वेश्चन इज साइलेंट अबाउट द सेम, देन वी नीड टू प्रिपेयर फ्लक्चुएटिंग कैपिटल अकाउंट. फ्लक्चुएटिंग कैपिटल अकाउंट मीन्स वी नीड टू प्रिपेयर ओनली वन अकाउंट, दैट्स कॉल्ड फ्लक्चुएटिंग कैपिटल अकाउंट. नाउ दिस थिंग कैन बी डिस्क्राइब विद द हेल्प ऑफ जर्नल एंट्रीज. In that term, how we prepare journal entries. Now suppose the journal entries come regarding interest and capital, regarding salary. So they are need to prepare two different accounts, or we say that in the entry, the accounting treatment of these conditions can be passed separately. Accounting treatment. Accounting is almost same, but need to understand that under which method, capital method, you need to pass the entry. If you need to pass the entry regarding fixed capital method, you have to open current account. If you need to pass the entry regarding fluctuating capital account, you simply write by A's capital account. Now, for example, suppose any partner is allowed interest on capital, say the amount 10,000, and B is getting 20,000. Suppose there are two partners are there, A and B. A is getting interest on his capital 10,000 and B is getting 20,000. How you need to pass journal entry in the case of both the capital account? First thing, the entry will be interest on capital account debit to A's current account to B's current account. A is getting 20,000, B is getting 10,000, the total interest they are getting both 30,000. Now this entry need to pass only when the question is silent, when the question says you need to prepare the capital account under fixed capital method. Under fixed capital method you need to open the account called current account. But under fixed capital method, you cannot write like this. You have simply write interest on capital account debit to A's capital account to B's capital account. This is the entry you need to pass. Under fluctuating capital method, you need to pass this entry interest on capital account debit to A's capital account to B's capital account. Total interest is same, 30,000. They both are getting, A is getting 20,000 out of 30 and B is getting 10,000 out of 30. So these are the only differences is under first capital method we need to open account called A's current account. Under fluctuating capital account we write simply to A's capital account to B's capital account. Now this time can be expressed with the help of a question. So I am writing a question over here so that you can further explain how we need to pass the entry, how can we prepare different ledgers under fluctuating capital method or under fixed capital method. The question here is, first I am giving you a simple question. Suppose please see the question very carefully. A and B are partners. I'm writing the question over here so that you can see it clearly and understand each and every term. A and B are partners. In a firm. Please say A and B are partners in a firm with capital of rupees. And A and B are partners with capital of rupees 60,000 and rupees 20,000. They are given, capital is given the question. Respectively, as on 1st April 2019. It means it's the accounting year starting from 1st April 19 to 31st 3 20. Okay, the net profit given the question is net profit before taking into consideration the provision of the deed for the year ended March 31st 2020 is rupees 24,000. Okay, the deed provides the following. The deed provides the following transactions. Now, what are the transactions given that? First is interest on their capital is to be allowed at the rate of 6%. The first condition is interest on capital is to be allowed at the rate 6%. Next is interest on drawing is to be charged. Interest on drawing is to be charged at the rate 5% per annum. It's also 6% per annum as well as 5% per annum. B is entitled to a salary. B is entitled to a salary of rupees 6,000 per annum. Means B is getting a salary of rupees 6,000. The space is left here. The drawings is in continuation with the question only. The drawings of A and B is, the drawings are given the question. The drawings of the partner A and B were rupees 6,000 and 4,000 respectively. Rupees 4,000 respectively. Important thing over here. And they also say, and interest on drawing for A is given, interest on drawing for A is given, the question is rupees 200, and for B is rupees 100. Now listen carefully. The rate of interest in drawing is given the question, but the amount is given. Interest on drawing for A is rupees 200 and for B is rupees 100. So we have to take interest in drawing of this amount. We cannot calculate the same. Because when the question is given the question, how many questions are given? What is the interest on drawing for A? What is the interest for drawing for B? So we need to take this into consideration. What is the amount given the question? Now the question arises over here. What we are going to do? What we need to prepare? As per the question, this says that pass journal entry. You need to pass journal entry and prepare PL appropriation account. As well as capital accounts. You need to pass journal entry and prepare PL accrual account and capital accounts under fixed capital method. And fluctuating capital method. Fluctuating capital method. That's the question. Now, from this question, you get able to explain the same how we prepare the journal entries regarding fixed capital method and fluctuating capital method, and how we pass the ledgers, how we prepare different capital accounts under these methods. So, first, we are doing under fixed capital method. And with your journal entry, how we need to pass journal entry under fixed capital method. You all know the format of journal entry. We write journal entries in the books of A and B. A and B are partners, thus we write journal entries in the books of A and B. You write debit side, credit side, you write ledger folio, date, we need to pass the entry of 31st March 2020. The books are closing on 31st March 2020 dates, and we write particulars. Now, first thing, this is a format of journal entry. Now, read the question carefully. The first thing they given the question, profit as per PL account. It's given the question, profit as per PL account is 24,000. The profit we need to transfer to PL appraisal account. The first entry pass, transfer of profit to PL appraisal account, profit and loss account debit. Two, profit loss appropriation account. Profit loss account debit to PL appropriation account. Profit transferred to PL appropriation account is given the question 24,000. I hope the first entry is clear. The profit need to transfer to PL appropriation account. The entry pass over here, PL account debit to PL appropriation account. The next entry is date will be common. Who is getting salary? Is given the question, B is entitled for a salary of rupees? Okay, 6,000 is given the question. The entry will be B's salary account debit. B is getting a salary of rupees 6,000. 2, B's current account. Now here, under fixed capital method, I told you we need to open a current account. We cannot say B's capital account. We have to open a new account, it's called current account. Because under fresh capital method, you need to prepare two accounts. The first one is called the fresh capital account, and the second one is called current account. So entry pass over here, B's salary account debit to B's current account. The narration will be being salary transferred to B's current account. Being salary provided to B or being salary provided to B's current account. Now, when you provide salary, when firm is giving salary, the firm deducted this salary from where? Because it's an expense for the firm, firm is paying out of its approved. And partner's salary is not a charge. I told you in my previous lecture, partner's salary is not a charge, it's an appropriation. The next entry pass over here, PL appropriation account debit. Account debit to B's salary account. Being salary transferred to PL appropriation account. Being salary transferred to PL appropriation account. Yeah, being salary transferred to PL appropriation account. The amount over here is 6,000. We are providing 6,000 salary to B. The same amount will be transferred to PL appropriation account or deducted from PL account. This is the first entry. We write open the most important part. The important part here, this is the important thing is, we cannot write B's capital account under fresh capital method. We have to write B's current account. And the same thing is transfer to PL appropriation account. Apart from this thing, A and B is getting interest in capital. The date remains same, only the space is slightly short over here. So need to prepare rubber. I need to write the new entry, the interest in capital. Interest on capital account debit. Who is getting interest? Both A and B. We write over here to A's current account and to B's current account. Well, let's say very carefully, A and B is getting salary. A and B is getting interest in capital. So A, total interest in capital, firm is providing 30,000, out of which A share is 20,000 and B share is 10,000. This is the important thing. Interest in capital. A share is 20,000, B share is 10,000. After passing guarantee, I will prepare PL accrual account. But first, understand this thing. Interest in capital account debit to A's current account and to B's current account. Now, need to be charged. Same entry 31st 3 2020. PL accrual account debit to interest on partner's capital 30,000 and 30,000. Listen carefully. Interest on capital, again a charge from partner's capital. How we write it? PL appropriation account debit to interest in it. It's an expense firm because firm is providing it. The next thing is, it will be same. Interest on drawing. A and B is getting interest on their drawing. So how will pass the entry? Entry regarding interest on drawing. It should be deducted from partner's capital. We write over here, A's current account debit, B's current account debit to interest on drawing. It's given the question, how much interest on drawing the firm is charging. A need to pay, the total interest on drawing is 300, out of which A need to pay 200. And B need to pay 100 rupees. It's given the option. B, interest charge on drawing. Now again, this need to be transferred to PL appropriation account. So how we write it? Right here, interest on drawing account debit to
PL APRO account, the PL appropriation account. The total interest the firm is charging is 300. So 300 will be transferred to PL provision account, credit side of PL provision account, because the income for the firm. The firm is charging interest on the respective drawings. So these are basic entry which take place under first capital method and both under fluctuating capital method. But the only difference is under first capital method we need to open a current account. Under fluctuating capital method we can simply write A is capital account, B is capital account to interest of drawing. Now obviously I need to prepare, I will review how to prepare PL appropriation account. PL appropriation account. I hope you all know that how to prepare PL appropriation account. If you know, you can start. PL appropriation account. As on 31st March 2020, right simply here, debit side, credit side, particular amount, particular amount. If you note down the question, please listen carefully. First thing, how much net profit is given the question? They say as per PL account, the profit is 24,000 rupees. We transfer the profit to PL appropriation account. So here we write by net profit transfer from PL account. Profit and loss account is given the question 24,000. Now I hope it's clear. Now profit is decreasing because the profit transferred to PL appropriation account. The new liability arises, PL account. So whenever liability increases, it always created. The entry here is by net profit transfer PL account. Basically, what is the expenses for the firm which firm is providing? Firm is giving interest on capital. We write over here 2 interest on capital. Now how many partners here? There are 2 partners. So we write here to interest on capital account A and B. Is given the question how much interest A is getting, how much interest B is getting. So A is getting interest 3600 and B is getting 1200. Let's make 1400 for both. 3600 for A, 1200 for B. Who is getting salary? Is given the question. Who is the partner who is getting a salary? B is getting a salary. To B's salary account is 6000. Is there any commissions here? No. But if their drawing is here, we write by interest, the charge on drawing. Interest on drawing account. A is capital account and B is capital account. The interest paid by B, A, I hope is by interest on drawing to A by A and B is given the question. 200 for A and 100 for B. Now, we pass all the conditions which given the question or which can be asking question. Now, how we write it? This 24,300 did all the expenses which given the question is 6 plus 4800 is 10,800. 24,300 minus 10,800, it makes 13,500. So we get 13,500 as a profit for the whole firm. Now this 13,000 profit is divided into A and B's capital account. Now important part over here is when the ratio is not given,
when the share of profit is not given. We always take in mind, when the share of profit is given, the profit share ratio is equal. I repeat, जब हमें रेशियो जब प्रॉफिट शेयरिंग रेशियो गिवन नहीं होता क्वेश्चन में तो हम प्रॉफिट शेयर रेशियो क्या मानते हैं इक्वल नाउ प्लीज कई बच्चे गलती करते हैं कि वो एज पर कैपिटल ले लेते हैं नो अनटिल अनलेस दे कैन नॉट आस्क यू कैन नॉट राइट एज पर द कैपिटल द प्रॉफिट शेयर रेशियो इज नॉट गिवन द क्वेश्चन वी हैव टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट इक्वली तो 20,500 डिस्ट्रीब्यूट इक्वली इट मेक्स
6750 फॉर ए एंड 6750 फॉर बी
Because the profit share ratio is equal. Now, this is the format of this is a question regarding PL appropriation account. How we prepare PL appropriation account? I hope you understand this thing. How we prepare PL appropriation account? Now, next part. How we generalize the transactions? How we prepare partner's capital account? Now, under fixed capital account, I told you we need to prepare two capital accounts. First one is fixed capital account, and the other one is current account. I cannot prepare one capital account. We need to prepare different capital account. As per question, see that the A's capital is different, the B's capital is different. So we need to prepare separate capital accounts for both A and B. Now, first thing is how we need to prepare the partner's capital account. We need to prepare fixed capital account under fixed capital method. Under fixed capital method. We need to prepare two accounts. First one is fixed capital account and next one is current account. So how we prepare fixed capital account? It's called capital account of A and B, fixed capital account of A and B, A and B. Debit side, credit side, write over here particulars. Amount in rupees. The first thing, alright, under fixed capital method, I told you we need to prepare two capital accounts. The first we are preparing fixed capital account. And I told you fixed capital account can be changed only for two purposes, only in two conditions. When a partner brings additional capital or when he is permanently withdrawing his capital. Now here, we write by balance breakdown, which is given the question. What is the opening balance which is given the question? So as per A's capital is given 60,000 and B's capital is given 20,000. It's very easy part. If you understand this thing, it's very easy. So A's capital is 60 and B's capital 20. There's no permanent drawing is there in the question. There's no permanent drawing. There's drawing is here, but that drawing is out of profit, not out of capital. We're not saying A and B withdraw the permanent amount of capital. So simply, nothing in debit side, we write over here two balance CD. Because our opening balance is mean the capital is not changed at all. The first capital not changed at all. 60,000 and 20,000. This is a balance CD, the closing balance. 60,000 and 20,000 here. We are balancing it. Now, this is a portion of fixed capital account. So, I told you fixed capital account changed two conditions only. When any partner brings additional capital or the permanent withdrawing. So, both the conditions are not given the question. The capital account remains same. I hope it's clear. Now, when we prepare fixed capital account, we need to prepare one more account. That's called current account. I'm preparing here only current account. So that it can be clear to you. Now, current account. First, maybe this is partner A and this one is partner B. Again, same thing, credit side, debit side, particular, amount in rupees, again particular, this for A and this for B, amount in rupees for AB. Now, the current account balance is not given the question. So, what are the changes occur during the year? we have to write all the things. The first thing, how much interest A is getting? A is getting interest on his capital. Does his capital increases or decreases? Increases. Because he is getting interest on his capital. We write here by interest on capital account. Now check the question. Check the PL question. How much A is getting? Is given the question, how much A is getting? A is getting 2600 and B is getting 1200. First thing, similarly, who is getting salary? By salary, B is getting a salary rupees. Not A, B is getting a salary rupees 6000. We write here 6000. Important part. Next is we need. It doesn't prepare PL appropriation account till yet, I hope. Oh, sorry. By profit sharing. PL appropriation account. How much profit we are getting? We prepare PL appropriation account. From the PL appropriation account, we get the amount of profit distributed to each partner. So by profit transferred to A and B capital account. So what is the share of A's profit? It's same. I think it's 6750. 6750 for both A and B. Please check the PL provision account if you cannot understand this thing. We prepare PL provision account so that we can find out the net profit divisible to A and B. The first thing, they are getting interest in capital. They are getting, B is getting a salary rupees 6000. Their profit share 6750. Similarly, they withdraw something. They withdraw the money. We write over here two drawings. During the year, check the question, how much A withdraw or how much B withdraw? So A withdraw 6000 rupees. During the year, check the question, it's mentioned the question, and B withdraw rupees 4000. When they withdraw the money out of profit, it should be debited to capital account. Similarly, they have to pay interest on drawing. We write two interest on drawings like this. Two interest, how much interest going to pay? It's mentioned the PL provision, it's mentioned the question also. A need to pay interest drawing 200 and B need to pay 100 rupees. 200, we write 100 over here. Now, apart from this thing, koi aur transaction nahi hai. Check the question, if any other transaction is given or not. There's no other transaction is given. So we now close the total of debit side minus total credit side, we get the closing balances of current account. The total of debit side of A, if you add those in, is 6750 plus 3600 is spent 10350. If you calculate total side of B's capital account is 13950. And 13950. Now, total of credit side minus total of debit side. So 10350 minus 6200, the current account balance is given for A is 4150. And for B is 9850. So these are terms, how to prepare capital accounts, fixed capital account and the current account. We get the balance of this. This is a current account balance, current account closing balance during the year. Now this is the first thing, how we prepare fixed capital account. But the most important part over here is how we prepare fluctuating capital account. Now fluctuating is what? It's fixed plus current. Now I will show you how. Now this is, we prepare two capital accounts separately. The first one is fixed capital account and next one is current account. Now the second portion, if the question says you need to prepare capital account, simply capital account, it means we need to prepare fluctuating capital account. Koi difference hai ki nahi hai? Check karte hain dono mein kya difference banega. I hope you know down all the question. Should I rub it?
Now capital account under fluctuating capital matter. Formally same, capital account, particular, A, B, particular, A, B, debit side, credit side.
It's all been same, how we were fluctuating capital account. First one is A,
but the opening balance given the question. In fluctuating capital method, we write combined thing.
What are the opening capital and what are the changes occur during course of business? In simple terms, the current account, the current plus fixed capital account, we get fluctuating capital account. Let's check it out. The opening balance given the question is the A's capital account is 60,000 and the B capital account opening balance is
20,000.
60,000 and 20,000. What are the changes occur? We already preparing current account by interest in capital. How much interest A is getting? Is given the question. A is getting the interest amount is 3600 and B is getting 1200.
So this is 3600 and 1200. Similarly, who is getting a salary? By salary account. B is getting a salary rupees 6000. We write over here 6000.
If any partner is getting commission, we write over here by commission. Apart from this thing, during the year, they withdraw something? Yes.
We write over here, to drawing account. How much A withdraw?
Is going to be 6,000 and B withdraw 4,000.
6,000 and 4,000. Next is, they need to pay interest on their drawings. We write over here, to interest on drawing account. How much A need to pay? As given the question, A need to pay 200. And we need to pay 100 rupees
at the interest rate. Now, there is no further thing is given the question. One more thing, PL appropriation account.
We need to write profits by PL appropriation account. Appropriation account.
By PL account, they're getting profit. We need we pay PL appropriation account. From PL appropriation account, we get how much the net distributed on the profit to A and B. So A share of profit is 6750 and B share of profit is 6750. You already find out in P&L provision account
the total of this side like this at the credit side of A. Similarly for B, the total of credit side of A is 70,350
and the total of credit side of B is 33,950.
33,950. 70,350 and 33,950.
Now they add this total of credit side minus total of debit side, we get the closing balances to balance CD. This is the closing balance of total capital account under fluctuating method. The capital, the balance is 70,350 minus 6200. We get 64,150. And for B, we get
28,950.
The closing balance. So this is a fluctuating capital method under which we can able to find out that what is the end balances of A and B. Now, if you compare the fluctuating capital account and current account, you are able to understand this thing, that total of fixed plus current of A is 64,150. Please check it. And the total of B is 28,950. In simple terms, we can say that what is fluctuating capital account? Fluctuating capital account is the sum of fixed plus current account in most of the conditions. I hope you understand the same, how we prepare capital account, how we prepare the different types of capital account. First one is fixed capital account, current account, and the combination is combination of both fluctuating capital account. So I hope you are able to understand all this. In my next video, I will teach you how to calculate interest on drawing. This is again important part. How we calculate interest on drawing and what is the terms and conditions regarding interest on drawing. So stay tuned and please remain safely. Leave at home. Goodbye.